Andrew Bang by Procrastina. It's a warm day, more like a day that makes you sweat every bit of liquid in your body. I sat in my philosophy advanced class, tapping my green pen on the desk. I suddenly got the munchies to write about something. A few days ago, an acquaintance of mine, I couldn't really consider her as a friend, saw me writing a poem. It was just the usual word fool I do. She asked me, "So you're a writer?" With a sarcastic grin, I held back and didn't answer. I badly wanted to say yes, but I couldn't. Something held me back, more like a lot of things. She then again asked me, "You're not a DevCom nor an English major, right? I know you're an art student." I gasped and continued writing. I was a bit ticked off, so I didn't bother answering any of her questions. She kept on asking a lot of questions, how I write and why am I into writing stuff. I didn't pay attention. I'm good at not paying attention. I rarely look at her face, I just continued to write. She then realized that her presence was annoying me badly, very badly. So she bid goodbye and I replied with a nod. "Finally, duh," I said to myself. I ended up writing the phrase down. I chuckled, how bizarre. I just found it funny. My left hand followed my brain automatically. After a few more minutes, I decided to stop writing. I went inside the room to get my stuff and say goodbye to my friends in the department. It's 10:45 when I went out of the department. The weather still sucks. I sweat automatically when I step out of the gallery. Another yada yada day for me. Another frustrating day. I was alone and I walked slowly. I usually walk fast, but that day was I wanna walk slowly today. I was lamenting on a lot of stuff as I walked home. I know, I'm stuck on this freeway in my mind. I love to write, yet I love used and saturated circles. Sometimes I write more than I make lines, which is very frustrating. Words are my army. For more than 6 years, I have written countless of poems, jotted down thousands of words, and not caring about grammar or syntax. I didn't care whether people liked it or not. The only thing I cared about is whether my words are alive. Unsound, I know. But I always believe that words live in breath. They have this sweet breath that makes me calm, make me sane after taking all the rage in my brain. I never followed a format. I never edit. I just write whatever comes to me, like how I pretended autumn leaves kiss me when I'm miserable. A spontaneity? Not quite. More like insanity. I've always used that word, insanity, only in writing that I can be insane. I cannot walk around talking to people reciting E.E. Cummings poems. I don't consider myself a writer, and I never wanted to. I know I will be criticized and scrutinized by real writers. I know what I'm talking about. I have shared the same DNA configuration with a professional writer. And she probably would be surprised if she will ever read this. Not to mention, edit the structure and the grammar. Duh, the weird expression I make when I'm speechless. At this moment, I am having writer's block. Contradiction. I just said I'm not a writer. Oh well, let me correct myself. My brain just stopped working. I am in front of my house when I yawn. I'm sleepy, I said to myself. I opened the door and saw my pen lying on the floor. I decided I'd write something before I cook my lunch. I wrote a few words, few meaningless words that describe my soul for a second. Live. Float like that brown paper I accidentally stepped on. Dim the light and seize the day. In darkness, I will find coldness and warmth.
This is Maro Kalisa reading you a book. Have a nice day.